Today on Minus Studio, let's get all reverby. Welcome to Minus Studio. My name is Nathan. With me, as always, is my pedal acquisition specialist, Ronald. Today on Minus Studio, we're going to talk about the TC Helicon R1 reverb pedal. So this is just a vocal reverb pedal. So I bought this pedal to use on my Christmas live stream tutorials.
Oh, come let us adore him. Oh, come let us adore him.
Because I was going to be doing a lot of singing and a lot of talking, and I wanted some reverb on the singy bits, but not on the talky bits. So I thought a reverb pedal would be the easiest and best way to do so. So I bought this, the TC Helicon, I'm gonna say Helicon, R1 reverb pedal. That way I could just turn the reverb off and on when I needed to. This is also good when you are using a app that doesn't have built-in reverb, or you don't want to use the built-in reverb, like if you're leading worship on Zoom and you want reverb on your voice, or through OBS and you don't want to use the plugins, or on Facebook Live or straight into YouTube. Lots of apps out there that don't have reverb. I would say most apps probably don't have reverb, actually. And you can use this if you want to add some without having to go through other apps on your computer. This pedal cost me like $130-ish, I want to say. I'll have a link to the pedal in the description below this video as well if you want to check it out. The pedal is fairly simple. On this side over here, you have a knob that controls the style of reverb that you use, room, cathedral, etc. Over here, you have a knob that controls how much reverb is going out. On the back, you have USB power and regular power, DC power, is that right? And then you have your input and your output, both XLRs. This side, you just have your mic gain. Controls the gain of the mic coming into the pedal. On this side, you have a mic control button, which, unless you own a special mic that they make that can control this pedal, you won't ever use. I also like that it's got this nice rubber non-slip pad on the back. And you can see it was made in Canada, so it's like super polite. Let's get to testing, shall we? So first, let's just compare what it sounds like without reverb and with reverb. I'll be recording vocals through this Shure SM58, and then my guitar is directly plugged in. You are hearing the reverb only on the vocal mic. The vocal mic is the only thing running through the reverb pedal. Now, this wouldn't be my ideal setup for worship. I'd set up a bunch of condenser mics, but this is probably a more common setup and a much better way for you to hear the reverb isolated on just the vocals. So I will turn my reverb pedal on and off while I am singing through this hymn, and you can hear the difference. And you'll see my reverb pedal right here. For this, I will be using the hall setting, and it's set to a little less than halfway between dry and wet.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise his name, I'm fixed upon it, name of God's redeeming love.
So that was what it sounds like with and without reverb. And right now you can hear why you don't want reverb on while you're talking. You can notice it a lot more when you're talking. It sounds like I'm talking in a cathedral. You don't notice it nearly as much when you're singing. All right, now for funsies, let's just turn up the reverb all the way wet and see what happens. Okay, so all the way wet's a bad idea. All right, so now I'll click through the different reverb styles. I'll leave the dry and wet knob on 50%. And I'm just gonna click through the different styles so you can hear what they sound like. I'll just sing a couple lines from the song. I won't play guitar, so you can just hear the reverb on my voice.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise his name, I'm fixed upon it, name of God's redeeming love. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor, daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, Lord, take and seal it, seal it for thy courts above.
So you can get a little different sound with the different styles. It takes a while to set the style you want and then the amount of dry wet you want. You got to test it a couple times to figure that out. But you can get a pretty decent sound. And of course, if we want to go crazy, we can. How about like maybe a theater, really, really wet. See what that sounds like. You can add a lot of reverb.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace.
Probably a little more reverb than you want. And that's really all there is to this pedal. Just adds reverb to your vocals. You know what? Let me get rid of all this stuff and then we can keep talking.
So I think it's a really good pedal. I think you can get a good reverb sound for a pedal. Now, I wouldn't choose to use a reverb pedal unless I had to. If I don't need to turn the reverb on and off and I can use another program like Logic, I'll always choose that. That reverb just sounds far better and it's far more customizable. But sometimes that's not an option. So if you're doing some sort of online worship service or concert or anything, like on Zoom or through OBS to Facebook or YouTube, and you need a way to quickly put reverb on a microphone and to be able to turn it on and off for when you're singing and talking, I think this is a really, really good option. If you want to get more complicated, you could buy a MIDI pedal USB that plugs into your computer and then like run that to Logic or Mainstage and then run the mic through there and turn the reverb on and off. Sometimes you don't want to be that complicated though. Sometimes you just need a quick way to add reverb. So that's what this is, TC Hilicon Voice Tone. If you need it, it's really great. Thank you so much for watching. Hope this was helpful. Please subscribe if it was, and I will see you back here next week for another video.
I can mute the guitar here.
Oh, jeez. And mute everything.